We continue tracking Hurricane Matthew as the hurricane continues its path up the Florida coast towards Georgia and the Carolinas. Its winds are causing potentially devastating storm surges to multiple states. Meteorologist Pete Mangione explains, new at 5:30.
While wind speeds for Matthew are still up in the air, storm surge is already a lock.
The video from Daytona Beach, Florida speaks for itself. Storm surge is and will continue to be a huge part of the weather story for Matthew. So what is storm surge? The National Hurricane Center defines it as, quote, the water from the ocean that is pushed onshore by the force of the winds. Just think back to Hurricane Sandy. The devastation on Musquamacut Beach and Westerly was the result of storm surge flooding. The exact path of Matthew will have an effect on where the most devastating winds end up. So there is some uncertainty about the extent of Matthew's winds. But there's a lot more certainty about the storm surge. That's because no matter where Matthew's strongest winds end up, they will be close enough to push massive amounts of water towards the coast of northern Florida, Georgia, and South Carolina. While it's not in operational mode yet, this is the prototype storm surge flooding forecast from the National Hurricane Center. It's not to be taken literally, but it shows the potential flood inundation. The spots where you see yellow and orange is where over 3 and even 6 feet of flooding are possible. And while there is often a lot of focus on wind as hurricanes approach, it's storm surge which is the biggest threat to life and property. I'm meteorologist Pete Mangione, Eyewitness News.